I wonder, what would happen if we actually had all of the main Yu-Gi-Oh! Protagonists in a rock band? Yeah, I know what you're thinking. What the hell are you talking about? I don't know either. I found this random picture and thought, you know, this reminds me of a video I watched by Little Karibo or Card Games FTW on YouTube now. So, yeah, I thought about that. I saw this picture. I'm like, well, this picture is missing Jack Atlas. But then again, knowing him, he'll probably just blow the place up and bam, no more concert. And bajillion of sad fans. But you're not here to listen to me ramble about that, are you? You're here to see a battle. So yeah, a battle I shall deliver right now after the intro. So cue it. Hey everybody, Leetspeed here, and I am back. I am going to be bringing you guys another Wi-Fi battle. Gee, what surprise is there to that, huh? Bet you never saw that one coming, huh? And you're probably wondering why my character is just randomly doing whatever he does. I like to do that sometimes, and I know that's kind of distracting, but hey, I'm a weird person. And yeah, people aren't going to like that, but hey, people like the weirdness. And if you have never really watched anything I have, then chances are we will not get along, I guess. But I don't know. It's really up to you. I have no problem talking to anybody, really. That's really up to you. That's not really up to me. It's up to you. So anyways, my match is against the legend of Super Kirby, I believe, at XX Meteor XX's live stream. At one of them anyways, because he does them quite often. But this was a while ago, so, yeah. I go for Ice Punch with Gallade, and I do hit that Golurk there for super effective. Now, I kind of went off straight for the attacking move and not switched because, you know, I thought he would probably set up a sub or something, and I want to get as much damage on him as possible before he does it. But he set up the Rock Polish, and I'm like, okay, I could just go to my Alamoa because he's probably not going to have the substitute, right? And he technically doesn't, but he does have the, Dynamic Punch, I believe. And yeah, that's definitely hinting that he's running the Dream World ability, No Guard. Now, this ability is actually shared with the Machop family. You know, Machop, Machoke, Machamp. And basically, with No Guard, any move that you launch against the opponent and any move that your opponent launches at you, they will always hit, even when you're like using Fly or Dig. Now, the only time that your moves won't hit is if they're using Protect or Detect, or something that completely nullifies an attack for one full turn. But yeah, I think those are the only two moves that could technically block No Guard hitting all the time. But yeah, since this thing also has Dynamic Punch, yeah, it's pretty much like a pseudo Machamp lead, you know, and with the Lumberry too, so I had to use Toxic twice because I want to try to wear this thing out because I know it's going to be kind of a problem if I don't get rid of it. And I want to try to stall out because really, there's nothing I could really go into. I mean, I could go to one other guy on my team to block Dynamic Punch, but the Confusion Hacks is going to hurt. So, yeah, I really don't want to risk that or anything. So, I go for Protect. I actually snapped out of Confusion right there, which is pretty crazy. So, now I'm pretty much at full... She's pretty much at full health, and Golurk dies. So, it's pretty much going to be a 6-5 already right off the bat, and I'm looking good at the moment, but that might change in just a few moments, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, I kind of spoiled it just because of the fact that this thing shows up. Now, yeah, he sends a Behem, I believe. I think that's how you actually pronounce the name, Behem, which I know is like B-E-M. I believe that's like the reference bug eye monster or whatever. But, yeah, I'm going to go for the, I think I went for the Scald here and I don't switch out. No, that's kind of a bad play on my part. Now, the only reason that I would have for staying in was to see what attack he would go for. I guess I wanted to see whether he have like Energy Ball or T-Bolt. Because I know that usually they don't run both. They usually have Calm Mind, Recover, Psychic, and then one other move. At least that's what the Calm Mind set, the ones I've seen have anyways. So I saw T-Ball, I'm thinking, okay, I can use Rhyperior later on if I need to. Now, I went to Gallade, and then I went right back into Alakazam predicting the Psychic because I want to try to do as much, you know, residual damage as possible. And on a resisted Psychic, I thought maybe Alakazam could live one, but he just went for the T-Ball, which that kind of did throw me off a little bit. So that plan went down the drain, as the Mario Bros might say in the Super Mario Brothers Super Show. But I don't know why I'm talking about that. I mean, I know I grew up on it. I watched that as a kid, and yes, haters gonna hate, but it's true. I watched it as a kid, and yeah, I liked it. I know people don't like it, but I don't know. I mean, yeah, it's very weird. But anyways, enough of that. I'm gonna go to Rhyperior to take the predicted Thunderbolt, because he's only been going for Thunderbolt. So I thought, oh, he might actually go for it again, and I could just get him Rhyperior for free and maybe stall him out some more. But that does not work. And then, yeah, he went for Psyshock. Now, seeing the Psyshock, definitely Alakazam would not be living a Psyshock, because Psyshock is, while it's a special attack, special-based attack, it attacks the physical defensive side of the Pokemon. And Alakazam is very, very frail on the physical side. So even with it resist, it's not going to take any at all, especially with Calm Mind, with like one or two Calm Mind boosts. But I thought maybe it could live a Psychic from maybe plus one or plus two because it resists. And Alakazam has slightly better special defense. But yeah, just a bit more of me trying to figure stuff out. But go to Gallade, go for Close Combat, try to get as much damage as possible. I could have went to Rotom here, but I really didn't want to risk him setting up or something like that. I really don't want him setting up. So yeah, I just had to attack really just to kind of see what he would do. He just went for Earthquake. Now, I take out the freaking Rhydon with HP Grass, and then I just go for the T-Wave on this incoming Maractus. Something that I don't see that often, but yeah, kind of for a good reason, but at the same time, this thing is kind of annoying. It went for Grass Whistle, first of all, which actually hit, which I'm like, wow, are you kidding me? No pun intended for that, by the way, just because it's the RU tier. But seriously, are you kidding? And it hit, that's like 55 accuracy. Now, I know a lot of people are actually talking about the whole accuracy thing. I know Rick was talking about it, Shofu's talking about it. Like, some people in like some of the latest narrations, they talk about like accuracy moves of Focus Blast, you know, trolling, Stone Edge trolling and all that shit. And hey, that's how it goes in these battles. Like, you never can hit like Stone Edge when you wanted to, and then sometimes you never get a burn with Skull when you want to. In fact, yeah, got wrecked by that Crawdon because of the fact that I didn't even get any burn hacks. Anyways, he brings a Skull Feed as I wake up and went for Air Slash, then I went for the T-Wave just because I know I could live one hit and then I could get extra lefties recovery basically, and that's where we are. There we are, we're caught up now. So he's gonna go to Scyther, he's gonna go for the Swords Dance, which is fine because I'm just gonna go for the T-Wave. I guess there isn't much else he could do, because even if he went just straight out for the Pursuit or Quick Attack, it would not KO, because I do have some defensive investment on this Rotom S. And yeah, you saw him in the intro, but now you get to see him. And yeah, nickname Guessing Time. You know, if you know where this is from, you are again a beast. And if you don't, that is okay, because not everyone has played the game where this reference is from. But chances are you have friends that do, so yeah, maybe you can phone them for help. You can phone them for help. Okay, that's not funny, but yeah, you can probably ask them or something. But he goes to Maractus. I'm going to go for the... I think I went for Air Slash, and he went for freaking Grass Whistle and hits again, so I'm like, wow. Hit twice in a row, but he gets the Paradox here, so I'm like, well, that kind of makes up for it. That really does make up for it in the long run. So yeah, he goes with a Synthesis just to recover the full health. I'm like, really? You're going to really do this? He cannot hurt me that much because his only attacking move is Giga Drain, which he resists. And the fact that he's paralyzed, so Hax is going to work in my favor eventually, and I can just take him out. What he'd have to do is, well, he gets a crit here with just half. So I'm like, all right, well, that was just minor annoyance, but that is how it works in Pokemon. Sometimes you get random crits that don't even matter, but you just kind of get annoyed because you're like, oh my god, that's just annoying. It's just that kind of weird feeling you get whenever you get that kind of hacks. But yeah, another thing I want to actually point out about the Rotom. I know a few people actually pointed this out, but Rotom in this Jenny's part flying now because all the Rotom forms were part ghost in addition to their electric typing. Rotom Wash is water type now, water electric, and then Rotom Heat is the fire electric, Rotom Grass is grass electric, Rotom Fridge is ice electric, and then we have the regular Rotom, which is ghost electric, which is pretty much the same as before, and then you have Rotom as being electric flying. Now, you want to know what's so redundant about it? Think about it. First of all, the Rotom forms have Levitate, which protects them from ground-type moves, right? Now, when you add the flying type to Rotom S, and the fact that you can add a balloon to it, yeah, you could literally have triple immunity to ground. And heck, if only Rotom S got Roost, that would have been pretty beast. Because you can, like, paraflinch and Roost, that'd be so messed up. But, yeah, that's just... Seriously, Rotom S is like the most redundant Rotom form in the game right now. In fact, it's probably one of the most redundant Pokemon in the game in general. I don't know. That's just my opinion, but it's that redundant. But anyways, that's pretty much going to be the end of the game. And we should definitely rematch again sometime later, The Legend of Super Kirby, because this match was pretty interesting. And I do like seeing a couple random guys like that Maractus, which is something I've never seen, and then Behem, something I haven't seen in a while, and then, you know, there's Scyther and Golurk. Golurk I've seen a few times, and actually, I do plan on using a Golurk soon. Not sure when I'll actually get a successful battle with him on the team, but it should come eventually. I'm not sure. Even if I had to break the order of uploading and upload that match first. But, yeah, that's pretty much going to be it. And I have been rambling again, and haters are going to hate on that rambling. But, hey, I know some of you guys like the rambling, so I guess it doesn't matter. I guess the majority... I guess I can leave you with this question. Like, how many of you guys actually like the rambling that I do at the end of the videos? I guess leave your comment on that, and I'll see you guys another time. So, peace out, guys. I'll see you later. Peace.